Ramadan Kareem, Ramadan Mubarak. This is going to be a special video. I want to discuss a particular matter because I got a lot of questions over the last couple of days to ask what happens when the fasting day is very long in Ramadan. What do we do? And I want to make a couple of disclaimers before I answer that question. So obviously in the first generation of Islam, Muslims didn't really encounter northern cities that the sun never set, or that there was a constant nighttime or constant daylight, or that the day was, you know, 20 hours, 22 hours, etc. So this particular issue is an issue that was discussed and debated later throughout Islamic law. And in that regard, it's a matter of ijtihad, meaning that there are different opinions. And I am going to give the instructions out how to follow one opinion. I'm not negating the other opinions. I'm aware that they're there, and I'm not here to debate the opinions. I'm here to provide guidance on how do you implement one particular opinion. So I want to make that disclaimer in the beginning so people understand what this, you know, what this video is about. So according to the fatwa of the National Fatwa Office of Egypt, Dar al-Ifta al-Misriya, I'm going to explain what happens when the fasting day is more than 18 hours of daylight. So there's this hadith in which the Prophet ﷺ told us about the Dajjal, the Antichrist. When the Antichrist comes, one of the signs is that the day will last longer than 24-hour period. So the Sahaba, they asked the Prophet ﷺ, if we are alive at that time, what should we do? Do we just pray for as if it's one day? And the Prophet ﷺ, he said, no, you have to allot times and calculate the time so that you pray the prayers within a 24-hour period. So one of the things that the ulama took from this hadith is that there can be a situation in which the sun, the daylight, the heavens, the stars, the things that we use to determine the day, the times of prayer and the times of fasting can be off kilter. And when that happens, we have to approximate and we have to calculate in a certain way. So based on this hadith as well, the ulama determined that the source that they will use for proper timings will be the timings of Mecca. One, because the Quran refers to Mecca as Umm al-Qura, you know, the mother of all places, the mother of all cities. It's the place of revelation, it's the place of the Kaaba, it's the direction of prayer, etc. So they said that Mecca will serve as what we would consider the quote-unquote normal timings. And in that, they discovered that the maximum length of fasting hours in Mecca is 18 hours. So therefore, according to this opinion, they said, if the fasting day, if daylight is more than 18 hours, 18 hours and, you know, 1 minute, now we are over 18 hours, then we will follow the amount of fasting hours in the city of Mecca during this Ramadan. So, for example, if you went to a timetable of Mecca now, and this is the year 1439 of the Hijrah, 2018, of the common calendar, you will see that the fasting hour of Mecca is, I think, about 14 plus hours. I mean, you have to, don't take this, this is just an approximation. So if I live in a city in which the hours of daylight are more than 18 hours, I will, and I want to apply this fatwa, I will start with the Fajr of my time now in the city in which I live. I will look at my local mosque timetable, and Fajr will be like 2:30 in the morning, 3 in the morning, or something like that. And I will count the number of hours of Mecca today. So let's say, for the sake of this video, that it's 14 and a half hours. I will count from the time of Fajr, where I am now, and I will count 14 and a half hours, and then I will break my fast, even if it's daylight. Because the sun, the amount of day has gone out of what the Sharia has intended to be the maximum amount of time, just like the Prophet ﷺ discussed in the hadith of Dajjal. So I would break my fast after those amount of hours, and I could also pray at that time, Maghrib, for example. But on the issue of prayer, going away from issues of debate is mustahab. You know, al-khuruj min al-khilaf, mustahab, as we say. So because there are differences of opinion, one could break their fast following this fatwa, and they could delay their prayer to the actual sunsets, you know, if they want to be with the community. But for example, if you are children, if you, you know, you're school aged, and, you know, Maghrib and Aisha are so late, you can also apply this fatwa to the times of prayer as well. So you would count the 14 and a half hours, just to use our example. You would break your fast, you would be able to pray, and then that would be that would constitute a valid fasting day. Now again, I understand that there are other opinions. And this video is not to discuss the Sharia minutia of these opinions. Rather, I'm providing guidance, inshallah, I hope it's clear, on how to implement one particular opinion. If the daylight, the hours of the day of fasting exceed 18 hours, then this is how you would determine the prayer time. Now, it's going to require, if you find yourself in one of these, you know, northern cities, for example, in Europe or Alaska or something like that, you're going to have to make a little bit of an effort. You're going to have to find the number of hours of fasting in Mecca. You're going to have to find what time Fajr is in your local city. And you're going to have to count those hours, you know, to see when you're going to break your fast. And in general, when we have differences of opinion, valid differences of opinion, we cannot criticize each other for following one opinion or another. The only time we can criticize one another or legitimately be criticized is if we go against the consensus. And this is an issue in which there is no consensus. It's an issue of ijtihad, of independent legal reasoning that the ulama have, you know, debated and continue to debate and provide guidance. I'm simply providing an explanation of how to implement one. I hope this is clear. If there are any questions, you can email us and we can answer them. Have a blessed Ramadan. Wallahu a'lam.